Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding why 7.6% growth is hard to square, written by R. Nagaraj. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 3, plus this is important for public administration and economics optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the new way of calculating the GDP is not reflecting the real picture of the Indian economy. This editorial is also about how we need to tinker with the new methodology in order to get a better picture about our economy. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all, we need to know about certain concept, the concept of gross domestic product. Now, what is gross domestic product? Gross domestic product means the total production of the economy. Now, in this gross domestic product, we can delve deep into it. Now, delving deep into this gross domestic product, this GDP can be of two types. It can be a nominal GDP or it can be a real GDP. Now, as far as the nominal GDP is concerned, it will be more than the real GDP. Now, what is nominal GDP? Nominal means you are adding inflation. You are considering the productivity of the economy, but along with the productivity, there is something added to that. Now, what is that? That is the inflation. That is nominal GDP. Now, then we have got the real GDP. Real GDP means the productivity, the true productivity, the substantive productivity, the actual productivity. Mehngai usme hum calculate nahi kar rahe hain. Aaj hamari classes 27,000 rupees ki hain. Kal mehngai ki wajah se wo 30,000 rupees ki ho jayegi. But the real value of the classes will always remain 27,000 rupees. So that is the actual value of the product without adding the component of inflation into it. Then we have got other subcategories of GDP. Now, the GDP at the factor cost, the GDP at the market prices. Now, what is meant by at the factor cost? Now, when you produce something, you have to sell it in the market. When you have to sell it in the market, you have to pay taxes to the government. When you have to pay taxes to the government, if these taxes are added to the value of the commodity that you are producing, then such kind of production will be known as GDP at the market prices or at the market value. On the other hand, we have got GDP at the factor cost. In the factor cost, it will be only and only the value of the product that you are manufacturing, that you are creating, or you are coming out with. In that case, you will not be adding the indirect taxes into it. Now, as far as this editorial is concerned, this editorial is basically about a concern that Mr. R. Nagaraj has with the current way of calculating the GDP. Now, what is the current? In order to understand the current way of calculating the GDP, we must understand the older way of calculating the GDP. Now, before last year, we were calculating the GDP on the basis of a base year, and the base year was year 2004 and 2005. So this was the base year on the basis of which we were calculating the GDP till now. But last year onwards, we have changed this basis. We have changed the basis to year 2011, 2010 and 2011. Now, when you equate both these years, now as far as the year 2004 and 5 is concerned, it was a year in which the Indian economy was doing stupendously well. This was the year in which the growth rates were touching about 10%. This was the year when the health of the economy was very good. So, any kind of projections that we were making on the by taking this as the base year, it was bound to be less in the current scenario, because the current scenario is the scenario of economic distress. Current scenario is the scenario in which the economy is performing very badly. Then last year we have changed the base to year 2011. Now as far as this year is concerned, this year had a very fragile growth rate. So when this year had the very fragile growth rate, when this year will become the basis of our calculation, then automatically we will see a higher growth rate in terms of statistical figures. Now if we will take this as the base year, the growth rates will go down. Why is this happening? This is happening. Now let us suppose somebody is poor, somebody is having a net worth of 100 rupees and his net worth has increased to rupees 150. In this case, there is a 50% increase in the net worth of the person. Now, another case, let us suppose that the base of the person was just 100, was just 10 rupees, and his net worth has increased to 150 rupees. Now, in this case, the growth rate is phenomenal. It is much more in comparison to the growth rate of this case. In this case, we are just having 50%. In this case, it is much, much, much beyond even 10 times. So, this is the reason why we are seeing this variation in the growth rate of the Indian economy. Now, the second change that was introduced in the economy was from the perspective of the methodology, the change in the methodology. Now, what methodology we have changed? Earlier, we were adopting the factor cost. Now we have changed it to the market cost. In this case, we are adding the indirect taxes. Along with that, we are subtracting the subsidies. Now, when we are adding the taxes, it automatically will give up a heightened, a ballooned, a beyond figure, an increased figure. Then there is another anomaly in the new statistical figures with regard to the domestic production in the economy of India, and that anomaly is with respect to the increase in the growth of the manufacturing sector. But when you look at the ground reality is entirely different. The manufacturing sector is performing very, very badly. The debts of the banks and the NPAs, they are increasing at a phenomenal rate. The Sensex is performing really badly. Agriculture is in total distress. FDI is not coming. We are not putting into any investments. The borrowings of the corporate sector has gone down. The automobile sector is not performing well. So these are the negatives. Then the third thing that I'm talking about here is why the manufacturing sector has done so well statistically. Now statistically, the manufacturing sector has done well because we have changed the definition. To change the definition of the manufacturing sector, we have actually borrowed certain things from the service sector and we've added those things to the manufacturing sector. Statistically, this is the reason why the manufacturing sector is giving up good signs. But the reality is, it is in a state of big lump. Then, apart from this, there's another area of concern. The concern means the database that we have used of the private corporate sector that we have taken from Ministry of Corporate Affairs. That is something that has not been made public. Now, in order to read more on this, please visit brainiki.com. You will find our brain map on this particular editorial. So this was all for the day. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-944-0000 in case you're interested by the video class in entire civil services preparation. And in order to view the information of the class that we're offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainyki.com. You can also install our applications. Name of that one of the number one application is Brainyki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And the second application is IAS MCQs Brainyki. Now you can find this application only on Google Play Store. And please do participate in the answer writing program. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.